So the project that you're, I guess, best known for when you were graduate students is this Brook project. So can you tell us a little bit about that? And this was a very important step in sort of the progression of GPU computing to something that we can do commercially today.
Yeah, back in the DirectX 9 days of computer graphics, GPUs started becoming truly programmable. People could express real programs, fairly short ones, maybe only 4 to 8 instructions long, that can actually, solve a shading problem like a face skin shader, fairly complicated stuff. A bunch of us in academia noticed that the performance of these GPUs was huge compared to CPUs of the day. The number of floating point operations you could do was an order of magnitude larger. So we studied and looked at how you could use GPUs for more general purpose things by hacking graphics APIs like DirectX. The research, while a lot of people showed that that was doable, and
But it was really hard.
It was really hard to program. In fact, you needed a PhD in computer graphics to do even basic mathematical kind of stuff. In fact, there are folks in finance that were hiring, game programmers to try to hack GPUs to solve financial problems. The research I did was basically study the more fundamental programming model around GPUs. What was it about GPUs that made them programmable and parallel, but also present a more cohesive programming model to a general, programmer, to let them think about GPUs in a more general way? In the end, the project was called Brook. It was an actual software, programming language for how to program in a general way GPUs on top of those existing graphics APIs, so that users could think about, more general data concepts instead of triangles and pixels and textures.
What sort of things did people write in Brook?
We wrote a ray tracer to sort of study, could a GPU actually implement a ray tracer, which was a fun thing because a lot of people said it couldn't be done. We did triangle meshing. We did a lot of simulation on grid kinds of stuff, thermodynamic problems, heat transfer problems, fluid flow kinds of problems. For the most part, it worked. It demonstrated the performance benefit. It was still early. They weren't fully general, so you did have to work around some of the hiccups. But from a research perspective, it achieved its goal of showing the potential of GPU computing.